However, if it's 2-0, they will get second. If it's a 2-1, Nongshim will get second. Let's have a look at all of these different outcomes of the standings. As we can see, if it's 2-0 for Nongshim, we'll get a tiebreaker between Afrika and Gen G could be sixth. Yes? And then, if it's a 2-1, then we get a tiebreaker between Live Sandbox and Gen G, and Gen G could be fifth or fourth, depending on how things go. Kind.
And if you were a T1 fan and you won your last series, you would have wanted Gen G to win. But now you want them to lose, because if Gen G win, it's bad for you.
Yeah.
So it's topsy-turvy, everything's flipped. And I can't believe that it's the final match. Maybe not, I guess, with a tiebreaker, but of this. And it's not only the match matters, but literally the score has major implications.
Oh my goodness, how did Lucian last all this time? Okay, well, that's the perfect option here. Ascentra can have an okay lane into the Lucian. However, the lanes now look absolutely beautiful here for Nongshim.
Which early, that's going to be great. Wow.
This is not a good matchup for the Syndra that we've seen historically.
That's insane.
That's a good scatter, as Gori's going to get electrocuted as well. As BDD is going to utilize the extra time. In fact, Force of Will as well. Make sure that he gets that minion. Another dash in from Gori.
The priority that was available for Duggan and Callum, who picked themselves up while we were... Good
old. That's the Pale Cascade from Pina comes on in there. There's the flash forward. That's a really, really dead Lucian. As Rascal comes through, grabs himself a first blood. And what were we saying about the Renekton?
They were like Brutal, whose laning presence and team fights were great. But this kind of map play, oh my god. Oh, feels bad, man.
Yeah.
Oh, the ward. Yeah, that is a very, very damn
nice
false sense of security. As
Jim, I've got Shelly down to half health as Clid is going to pick it up. Say thanks for the leash for the moment. Q gonna miss from Peanut. Scatter the weak now on cooldown. This could be a big deal. It's all five members here for Nongshim as Life looking for the wrap around. Chains of Corruption come through as Life gets right into the front line. I mean, Peanut tried to do it, but it just did not work. The Moonfall just does nothing right now as the culling comes on through. And it is going to be the Herald picked up by Ruler of all people. And I absolutely know why, because he's taken that to the bottom lane and he's taken all of that money. Never put Skullin is okay. Rascal's in trouble now. Is Rich going to get sliced, diced, and then gets himself an assist? Immediately, as Ruler almost with his backup as well, as now Rascal looks for the stun, but actually doesn't need to use it just yet. There's the slice, but doesn't have the dice. There's the culling, and BDD will say goodbye. Clid going to pick up that kill.
Because if Rascal actually answers that all in, you might be in deep trouble.
Well, a lot of vision here coming down as Gen G looking for their window. Some orbs on the ground, which is scary. Peanut going to lock down the Drake. It's only the second, not a huge deal. But now, potential fighters. Rascal already below half health. Here's the dive from Gen G. The door is fantastic, blocking the True Shot Barrage as the culling goes entirely wide. As now, Rich trying to get over the wall, but it's not going to work. Peanut's already dead. And now, Nongshim are completely scattered. But are you going to be standing on a ward here, as you can see. Life just trying to play goalie. See what he can actually stop, as I expect Gen G to try and do a bit of a turn here, but they've got the Baron down very low.
Have Smite.
Let's see whether they commit to it, as Nongshim looking to try and come on through. That is going to be the Smite used by Clid, as in goes Life. I don't know whether an engage is exactly what they want, as Kellen takes a lot of damage despite the door.
And everyone gets wiped with the health bar that low. It's done, right? You lose the advantage, full control over to the map to Nongshim, and this is such a messy fight. Corrupting Arrow doesn't ever actually hit anyone. The calling gets sized really nice, and it's Ruler and BDD basically playing prison guard while the rest of Nongshim is trying to get into the pit, because they want to help out Peanut, who was stuck there. But it was just Kellen who was available here to help him. And yeah, with Clid and Rascal being as low as they are, I think I don't mind the call here. I think you never intend to actually fight here. Because you have Baron, why would you? But if Life doesn't go in there...
Zhonya's now complete, going to be much more durable in these instances. It's okay, there's a bit of a face check, but Peanut now surrounded by three people. Does use the Zhonya's, but immediately the knock-up from Clid. Love that! As Rich, not going to get stunned up just yet. As Clid looking for his opportunity, Kellen likely to go down, but does have a stopwatch. Life tries to flash away, but isn't going to be able to. As Ruler locks down that first kill, the scatter onto two is beautiful, but Peanut has the Zhonya's. Zhari going to throw out the ultimate, but it doesn't do too much. Moonfall also afterwards. Peanut flashes and is going to be able to get out to relative safety. It's a one-for-one in the end. Both of the supports going down. 1,000 gold lead and the Baron, rotating around them. Let's have a look at this one more time as Nongshim was setting up in the Fnatic Rush.
And if you hit that root, this play isn't even close. Rich just immediately dies, life, not having the greatest game on Leona. But then the combination of and then BDD, who is just, no, I'm going to flash. And I think BDD, if you look at his KDA's impact in this match, doesn't seem that threatening. But his Syndra has just been such...
Cleared in the mid lane, and Nongshim thinking about this as their opportunity. Chains of Corruption will connect. But now life looking to try and turn it around. Cleared not going to find the win becomes Lightning. But Gen.G are going to get inside track on this inhibitor pretty comfortably. Like, even if no fight occurs, Gen.G still win, right? Because they're in your base, destroying your stuff. Nongshim, okay, looking for the ultimate from Kellen.
This big. This is literally so big as they go in.
That's a big old flash forward from Clid. Does throw down the ultimate as they break open the base in all three lanes. Now just looking to back away by the looks of things. Yep, they got what they wanted. There's the culling. Rascal just moves on forward and blocks it. Double stopwatches come on through as Peanut does have to flash away, but Clid is still going to die. Gen.G answer back. They're just not going to as now Nongshim piling on forward. The flash out from BDD, but it does absolutely nothing. And Gen.G, where was the response? It just wasn't there.
And that was such a beautiful turnaround from Nongshim, and I haven't finished yet. I'm talking about Gen.G. Why they're playing it slow? It's because they don't want this to happen. Exactly this is the risk that you run if you overextend and they throw a lot down. But if they do, I know who my POG vote is going to, because take a look at how much damage gets negated here. It is actually insane. The flash forward comes through. So here, no damage, right? Can't actually reach the backline. And this is why the Kaifex stop, this is what the value of a Surreal Does Grudge really comes to fruition. Clint doesn't have his ultimate. And then, yeah, you stole a little bit of time here. But again, Gory and Doctum are safe. They're fine. They don't care at all. And it's these moments of weakness that have become so synonymous with Nongshim. The moment they see them, they smell them, they trip. Like, everyone just flashes forward. It's like five men just go, 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 go. And they all go. Like one unit. It's beautiful to watch.
So it was 5 seconds on this Cloud Soul. Oh, Kellen, he's gonna get locked down and Ruler trying to chase after him, but he has the Unbreakable once again. Baron as well, but this should go down very, very quickly. So this will be the Cloud Soul. Peanut spotted on this ward.
Game. You're one game away from getting knocked out of the bye.
Yeah.
Right? Like Nongshim can still drop the third, and that's the big one. Double Kia, dip. They're relaxing, you know, they're sipping their drink.
They're like wondering whether they're going to be first or second. They're like, ah, well, we don't have the Gen.G have available. Now they're going to close on in. This is going down extraordinarily fast.
That's it?
It's just going to be bursted. There are two blue trinkets there, but it's not going to work out. Unbreakable, not even necessary, as it's a bit wide on the True Shot Barrage. As Peanut getting poked down, over goes live, looks for Rich, but he has a stopwatch. Can he survive afterwards? It's a question. The answer's going to be no, but now the entire culling eaten by Rascal, cleared in trouble, as the GA is going to go down for both the jungler and the top laner of Gen.G, but they haven't lost anyone. And there is now no Rich. And no inhibitor turrets at all.
Protect this wave.
Teleport to come through here as Nongshim. They're committing. They're going to be able to take this inhibitor. Doctor, I'm going to take half of his health bar there from Ruler. Let's see whether Gen.G have a team fight in them. As Peanut going to get stunned. The flank is beautiful from BDD. And he takes out the Diana. She's so important for this team composition. As now Gen.G looking to close on in. Doctum limping away from this one. Wimpingum Lightning does not land, but the Mystic Shots do. And Gory cannot escape. It's a triple kill from Ruler as BDD dives on top of Rich. And he is not going anywhere. The Shock Blast misses. Zhonya's has to be used here as the rest of the team comes on through. And BDD is still going to actually flash out of the way of this one. You may as well, you better be safe than sorry, as Ruler has decided that he's done with this game. And Gen.G will finally, at 43 minutes, end game one.
What a nail biter, Atlas. Whoo! And everyone that's like, well, these two teams, the stakes on this final game are so incredibly high.
Do you know what just happened? Gen.G guaranteed that they will not be sixth place.
It felt like he had no impact, and that kind of started a somewhat of a slump. Yeah, that is...
That's an example of a poke composition and what they're able to do, but unfortunately, not able to actually make it stick, make it count in this particular game. And it's a reason why they held on for so long. As you can see, like, something went wrong. there for Gen G.
ちょっと待って。ちょっと待って。ちょっと待って。ちょっと待って。ちょっと待って。ちょっと待って。ちょっと待って。ちょっと待って。ちょっと待って。ちょっと待って。ちょっと待って。ちょっと待って。ちょっと待って。ちょっと待って。ちょっと待って。ちょっと待って。ちょっと待って。ちょっと待って。ちょっと待って。ちょっと待って。ちょっと待って。ちょっと待って。ちょっと待って。ちょっと待って。ちょっと待って。ちょっと待って。ちょっと待って。ちょっと待って。ちょっと待って。ちょっと待って。ちょっと待って。ちょっと待って。ちょっと待って。ちょっと待って。ちょっと待って。ちょっと待って。ちょっと待って。ちょっと待って。ちょっと待って。ちょっと待って。ちょっと待って。ちょっと待って。ちょっと待って。ちょっと待って。ちょっと待って。ちょっと待って。ちょっと待って。ち He did it!
Up, up right there!
Right there!
이기자!
이기자!
스트레이에 잘 보일 기회야 이거.
강이랑 이거 안 좋을 것 같은데.